caro, narrobaro lo soli, lo soli. Arresta malo scuro, che scuro Sicilia.
The exhibition actually was born more than 3 years ago. That was almost now 4 years ago. And it's an idea we share together, the three of us. We are friends, we are curators, and we have, all of us, have been traveling and working extensively in Italy and in Finland in the contemporary art scene. We noticed that people coming from abroad was surprised to discover how many contemporary artists are in Italy and active today. So we wanted to bring to Finland the selection of the most interesting young and mid-career contemporary artists.
And how are the artists drawing the picture of Italy today? What do you think?
We selected the artist through the red line of happiness. We choose a subject for many reasons. Happiness was the subject that came out very strongly after the crisis of 2008 and became very popular. And it came also a book from an Italian journalist, Enrico De Aglio, that was talking about happiness in America, and it was quite interesting book because it tells stories of people that actually destroyed their life to reach happiness. So we started to think about what is happiness, today in Italy during the crisis.
Yeah, and the second step was concerning the curatorial process to find the right artists that were closer to our goal of the exhibition. So we started to make a selection of them. We visited their ateliers, and then trying to find the right artwork that was very close to our ideas, concept of the exhibition.
And according to you, what is the state of Italian contemporary art in the international art world now?
Yes, people think out of Italy think that Italy is just a Renaissance, Baroque, ancient antiquity. That is true, and we were very focused on conservation in our culture. But now I think that it's time to add a new chapter to this to this story, and the chapter of contemporary art.
Yes, the contemporary art is very strong, and it has always been very strong in Italy, of course.
Yes.
You are a land of arts and beauty anyway. But what do you think, how do the artists of this exhibition take into account the very important question of today, all the ecological questions and the climate change?
Hot topic. There are some works in the exhibition that deal with this. There is a wide range of topics that goes from communities, to nature, to history, to art, and there are at least three works that come to my mind that deal with the theme of ecology or the climate change. The first of which is the installation by Marzia Migliora, that was co-produced by the Serlachius Art Museum together with the Italian Council, so it's just made for this exhibition, and it's called The Spectre of Malthus. So she deals with this installation with the idea of exploitation of natural resources, the idea of work, which kind of utopia we have in our mind when we think about happiness that is very much linked to richness, money and wealth, considering material thing. And the second one, it's the work by Federica Di Carlo. She's a young artist, and she presented a work that focuses on the representation of a rainbow, kind of symptom of the change in the climate, in the ecology. So how the earth is changing, if also the rainbow changes with with this changing of the of course the atmosphere and everything. So I think it's interesting.
Yes, and the third is by Pietro Ruffo. Yes. The third work, because with Migration Globe and Italian Pieces, it explains how people is starting to move from own countries to go abroad to find the new places where to live better. And so what's happening now today, so it's like a cycle of time and the events they are. Like a cycle, they are going to repeat in the time.
Yes, it's actually, that's interesting what she says, because the illustrations, the drawings that he uses to represent people climbing Italy, for example, or migrating in on the globe, when you come and you see the work, the first things that we have thought was that it was also connected to the migrations, the mass migrations that all the world is experiencing everywhere, from people leaving escaping their countries, escaping escaping the poorness because of climate, because of economy, because of corruption.
Yes, I think Pietro Ruffo is one of the artists in our exhibition that is very Italian, but at the same time very international, because Italy is a country that has to deal a lot with the refugees coming from the south.
Yes, and also he's coming from the south of Italy, so probably he's very close to this theme.
Another very Italian artist is Silvia Camporesi.
Yeah.
He's photographing the kind of most beautiful and interesting places of Italy that the tourists don't know that they exist.
Exactly.
Yes, also Marinella Senatore is one of them, because she comes from the south. Yeah. And she's very, very South Italian, and we can see
from her
Palermo in her beautiful
Palermo procession.
But she's also a very, very international artist who at this moment is in South Africa.
Yeah, and maybe also Goldi and Chiari, because they are connected to a part of Italian history in the 70s and in the 80s with their installation. So there are many.
Period connected with the crisis, no?
Yes,
was the period just before the crisis?
Yes. It's also traveling into Italy and Italian history. Also, this exhibition, it's a contemporary artist, but it touches really many areas. So it's beautiful. I think it's really fantastic to exhibit this artist in the happiest country in the world, that it's Finland. So the topic is really centered.
Yeah, and then we finish travel to Italy and feel happy when we are there.
So
we have video works by Jurian Carani, by Zimmer Frey, and Francesco Iodice, who are dealing with other kind of issues like the family, the sport, that is another two main topics for an Italian culture. And then also we have to mention Loris Cecchini and his beautiful installation, sculptural installation, that is dealing with the concept of the nature in another way, the reproduction, the possibility of life again in some way. And then to Matteo Montani with his work that is more connected with the spirituality of the happiness, how to reach happiness sometimes through spirituality is another way for many people.
Federico Pietrella also.
Federico Pietrella, that is another interesting work connected with time, because happiness is especially, sometimes it's tied to some moments of our life that we remind. And so through his work, you can recognize the time. So it's very interesting, the new technique that he used to... It looks like a painting, but it's not painting at the same time. Mm-hmm. And then Federico Solmi, with his work connected again with the history of Italy, we're representing three important protagonists, Giuseppe Garibaldi, Julius Caesar, and Cristoforo Colombo. Again, talking about the incongruences of the history, is interesting because he tried through ironic way to explain how history can change, can be interpreted, and so on.
And then we have Occult, the duo of artists with a very surprising surprising works that you are all invited to come and discover at the exhibition. Yeah. Of course, there is a very beautiful catalogue published by Parus in three languages with essays, pictures, and it's really an excellent catalogue to accompany the exhibition, and also
in three languages.
Yes, and it's also in a way also independent from the exhibition, so it can last even when the exhibition is over. It's a nice view of Italian contemporary art that is really very, we are very satisfied with this. I hope you will too.
Yeah, for sure.